Beloved, we welcome you once again as we are learning pathways to prevailing prayer, what to do to get things to work. The Bible has spoken to us in so many dimensions, and we need to start acting on them instead of choosing the areas we want and leaving the others undone. Humility is everything. Harmony in relationship is everything in this kingdom. The commanded blessing will come. The glory will be released in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. It says, verse 14, once again, of James chapter 5, is any sick among you? Are you dealing with sickness? Are you dealing with infirmity? Then the Lord that chose this scripture for this morning, then is ministering to you. Exercise your faith in the stripe that Jesus received. I rebuke doubt and unbelief that says it's not possible. Beloved, it is possible. Many times prayer have been offered, and then God will touch you at home while you're asleep. God will touch you in the car. God will touch you at an unguarded moment. So believe that as I'm speaking, that the healing power of the Lord Jesus is manifesting in your life. Believe it in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. I know that I cannot touch you, but as I'm talking about it, I feel a heat in my hand. That's why I'm putting my hand in front of me. I said, believe that the healing power of the Lord Jesus is available now. Lord, we thank you for releasing your grace. I stand as an elder this morning, and we're rebuking headaches and back pains and all these ailments, spirits of infirmity. In Jesus' name, I rebuke you. Go from God's people in the name of Jesus. Incurable diseases. Lord, may the anointing increase to remove generational curses and incurable things. It is you, Lord, that, you know, it is you that heal. It is you, oh God, that does the healing. I pray in Jesus' name that healing will manifest in the lives of your people, even as you've chosen the scripture, in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. He says, is any sick among you? Let him call for the elders of the church and let them pray over him. Watch this. Anointing him with oil. He gave prescriptions, anointing him with oil, because the anointing of oil is how we impart the grace that the Holy Spirit brings. The anointing physically transfers the anointing of the Holy Spirit. But we anoint, not just anointing. Many times we take oil and anoint people. But you need to say the words, I anoint you in the name of the Lord. That's what the Bible commands. In the name of the Lord Jesus, I anoint you in the name of the Lord Jesus. I anoint you in the name of the Lord Jesus. Beloved, the testimony that Kenny Hagin gave years ago, when God told him to start healing school, and he said he taught healing every night for 6 months. And prayed and decreed for healing, and nobody got healed. But he persevered. The first day after the 6 months, people started getting healed until he left the earth. So this thing sometimes, it's a press, it's a fight. And we have to stand on it. Why? Because Jesus Christ already took the stripes. So it is not something that God is going to do. It's something that has already been done. And we're trying to dispossess the demons hindering us from receiving what Jesus has already purchased for us. Everything we're dealing with, whether it's a physical affliction or a soulless affliction or whatever affliction is, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we decree his name. We decree his name in the name of Jesus. One of the brothers gave a testimony Sunday how the mother had a stroke. And I've been teaching on the power of the name of Jesus. And he said he instead of calling the ambulance, he started decreeing the name of Jesus. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. He did this thing for 20 minutes, beloved. The mother said later on that she was just waiting on him to get through with the prayer quickly so they can call the ambulance. But he kept decreeing it until it connected. And beloved, after 20 minutes, he had a release. They called the ambulance anyway. When they got to the hospital and they ran the MRI, beloved, they saw that the old MRI said she had a stroke, but the new one says there was nothing. See, the healing manifested in the name of Jesus Christ. He took what was preached in church and acted on it and acted on it and acted on it until it worked. Because I'm not trying to receive a healing from God that he's yet going to do. I'm trying to receive a healing that was purchased for me when Jesus Christ died, when he took those stripes 2,000 years ago. So that changes the focus of my faith. I'm showing you secrets to prevailing prayer. You change from trying to get something to effecting what was already done. That's a fight to manifest what has been done. You see? And you will not run into demonic opposition until you start decreeing in these dimensions, because now they will have to release what they have been holding and hindering. But that correction needs to be made, because you can be praying to God and thinking that the Lord has not healed you. That's a hindrance. He healed you before you got sick. Satan made you sick. But you have to take what was purchased for you and use it to drive out what Satan has done. And you have to keep working on it and working on it like a technician until your heart and your faith rises to that level so the thing will manifest. Because many times Jesus said to the people, "Be it unto you according to your faith, not according to your feelings." So we must prevail. He says, "You call the elders of the church, let them pray over him, anointing him with oil in the name of the Lord Jesus." Not just anointing with oil, but anointing him with oil in the name. The power is in the name. The deliverance is in the name. Hope is in the name. Sanctification is in the name. Restoration is in the name. Victory is in the name of Jesus Christ. And we have to pronounce it and push against every wall until they fall in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Otherwise, Satan will use his opposition to talk us out of what is already ours. Healing is already ours. Salvation is already ours. The Holy Spirit is already ours. Sanctification is already ours. Righteousness is already ours. The grace of God is already ours. He said, "I've delivered you from the power of darkness." May we go for what God has already done for us. And may we receive it today in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. God bless you. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.